Tallahassee, Florida, weighing in at 253 pounds, Lucky Cannon!
A number of weeks ago, a mystery man, somebody, we really don't know who it was, put Lucky Cannon headfirst into an ice machine backstage here at FCW. Lucky Cannon claims he nearly got pneumonia from that, and everybody seems to think that Husky Harris was the culprit. Now, we've got no proof. We've got only incidental evidence. Husky Harris doesn't seem to mind that people are blaming him.
You've got a smirk on your face. Nothing matters unless you're actually...
It certainly has been all about Lucky Cannon for the past few months, but you were...
And so it should be. And so it should be. As I was saying, nothing matters unless you actually have it in black and white or the footage of it right there in front of you for the world to see. So we don't know if it was Husky Harris. I mean, perhaps Husky Harris wants us to think it's him and then it was somebody else. We don't know. Husky's a devious man.
Husky, I don't know how many conversations you've had with Husky, but he's a little off the rails as far as I'm concerned.
His opponent from Brooksville, Florida, weighing in at 300 pounds, Husky Harris!
Well, there's the man that allegedly put Lucky Cannon in the ice machine, and it has all been revolving, this entire story that's been going on between Bo Rotundo, Damian Sandow, Lucky Cannon, and Husky Harris over the past few weeks. It's just been this circle of insanity that's happened, and it might all come to a head right now. Lucky's going to have to actually get in the ring, though, instead of berating our ring announcer over his robe.
Lucky's a very psychological game player. You know, over the last months that I've been watching him, I appreciate the way that he plays with his opponent's mental capabilities, but I don't know if you can do that with Husky Harris because he seems to have—he's mental.
He's on a completely different train of thought than I think most of the FCW superstars and society as a whole might be.
There's nothing Harris. Wrong with that, though, right? I mean, that's good. It makes him—it's going to make him a winner.
And it makes you stand out.
Yes.
If you're a winner here in FCW, you might have what it takes. You possibly could have what it takes to become a winner in WWE because FCW is the direct conduit to a path in superstardom in WWE. You see Lucky Cannon's banner occasionally in the background here with that Florida heavyweight title around his waist. Lucky Cannon, love him or hate him, former champion, made a great showing on NXT, and I know that the future is bright in WWE for Lucky Cannon.
It's not so bright at the moment, though, because you've got 300 pounds of vicious animal chasing you around. And I say it all the time. Husky Harris scares me. He's just got that. It's great to watch because there's very few people intimidate me.
I think Husky packed on about 15 pounds from last week, according to our ring announce.
Oh, you cheeky swine.
I'm just saying he's only getting bigger and better and just more dangerous, and he's still so agile and so quick. But so is Lucky Cannon.
There's two types of muscles, you know. There's counterfeit and conditioned. Anybody that steps into the ring, they're all conditioned athletes. It doesn't matter what they look like. It's not all about big bulging biceps. It's about what you can do.
All right,
and how
now,
you perform.
Lucky Cannon is doing exactly what he's done for the past few months. Whether he's been the champion or not, Lucky Cannon's going to take the fight right to you. Hook of the leg, gets one, just two. But you're seeing right now why Lucky Cannon is a former Florida heavyweight champion, because what he's doing to the likes of Husky Harris right now.
And I'm very experienced compared to that. I'm sat here and I'm second-guessing myself. What would I do to Husky Harris at this moment? Because he's such an incredibly powerful, agile man. I don't know exactly where I would be because I'm not the one that's got to feel his power underneath, you know, underneath me. So
look at the leg right here.
It's a very tough call.
Well, I think Lucky's a little bit fueled by emotion, certainly in this match. He's got to be after being, quite frankly, embarrassed in front of the FCW Universe when he was found stuffed into that ice machine. So Lucky's got something to prove. He wants a little bit of revenge here on Husky, even if Husky didn't do it.
There's nothing more to fuel a man's hatred than being embarrassed in front of anybody.
I've heard it said, you won't forget what people do to you, but you'll never forget how they make you feel. And Lucky Cannon's got that on his mind right now as he's going, oh man, what did he get?
There's another transvestite joke there somewhere with that saying you just said.
Hook of the leg, hook of both legs by Husky, gets two. Lucky able to roll that shoulder, and once again you see why he is a former Florida heavyweight champion. Husky looking to put away Lucky, handful of tights, and Husky kicks out.
That shows you how well Lucky Cannon has scouted.
No, Husky you're Harris. Not with
I spoke too soon.
We saw this last week from Husky. This could set up that gigantic senton. Lucky barely making it to his knees right now. Up in the corner, dangerous spot. No. Collision right there. Looked like both guys knocked their heads right into each other.
One thing about Husky Harris, though, I'm pretty sure he's used to headbutting people. He's just got that look about him.
And Lucky saying, ow, my eye, ow, my eye. The referee very concerned, as he well should be. Oh, there's Sandow with a chair. Sandow with a chair right into the face of Oh, and Sandow just cracked the Florida heavyweight champion, Barrotondo. Sandow's out of here. Lucky Cannon hooked the leg. Husky got hit in the face with a chair, and Lucky got three.
Here is your winner, Lucky Cannon.
That all happened so quickly, but a very well-executed plan played out perfectly there by Damian Sandow and Lucky Cannon.
We got to take another look right here. Lucky Cannon, you see him faking. I don't know if he's faking, but he's saying his eye is injured, and Sandow came out of nowhere. Chair right across the face of Husky Harris. Barrotondo right behind to make the save, but Damian saw him coming and laid out the Florida heavyweight champion as well. Lucky Cannon, the only man left standing at the end of tonight.
Let's not take Lucky Cannon for granted. There's no way that he would have come into this match against such a ferocious competitor as Husky Harris without having a plan.
I'm getting word from the back as Lucky Cannon berating Barrotondo, the Florida heavyweight champion. It has just been signed that Damian Sandow will take on Barrotondo for the Florida heavyweight championship next week on FCW. For Mr. Regal, I'm Matt Marlaro. It's all said, it's all done. It's been real, it's been fun. We will see you next.